Good day. I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to make the transition from geometry involving points and lines to a geometry involving circles. And our main aim will be to introduce a proper definition for the notion of a circle. There are some obvious candidates. We could say that a circle is just a round shape, but that's a little bit too vague. We could say that a circle is a curve traced out by a compass, one of those tools used by the ancient Greeks. You put one end there and then you swing the other end around and it traces out a circle. That's a little bit too physical and not mathematical enough. A very common definition is that a circle is a set of points, which are a distance r from a fixed point O. So here is the point O with coordinates A, B, and we're looking at all those points x whose distance from O is exactly r. Now there's two major difficulties with this definition. One is that it involves an infinite set of points, which in fact it does not exist. The more carefully you think about what you actually mean by this infinite set, the more fuzzy and vague it actually becomes. Secondly, we'll see that when we go to higher geometry, to more elaborate curves, that there will be a good reason why this is not an appropriate definition. Another reasonable candidate is as simply the equation expressed by this x. So here we have not distance, but quadrants, which is the square of distance. So x minus a squared plus y minus b squared, that's the quadrants from a point x, y to the point O. And we're saying that the quadrants is equal to r squared. That defines the circle. And we could say that's the equation of the circle, in the sense that any point x, y that satisfies that equation lies on the circle. So a very good idea is to say that a circle is this equation. And we're going to do something that's very similar to that, except that we don't want to really focus on x and y. The x and y are not really essential aspects of this thing, because it's a little bit arbitrary. We could have also used z and w or r and s or some other variables. It's actually the coefficients of the x and y that are important. When we expand out the equation for a circle that we had, we see we get this equation here, involving x squared minus 2xa, a squared, y squared minus 2yb, plus b squared equals r squared. That's a special case of this general equation of degree 2, which we will see later on represents a conic. It could also represent a hyperbola, an ellipse, or a parabola, or some other configurations as well. The special case of the circle is characterized by the d and the f terms, the coefficients of x squared and y squared, being equal, and there being no x, y term, so that the coefficient e is zero. And that motivates our definition of a circle. A circle is nothing but a proportion of the form 1 to 0 to 1 to minus 2a to minus 2b to c. In other words, it's the six coefficients that are appearing in this formulation here when we look at the equation of the circle. A proportion is all that's needed because when we multiply all those numbers by a fixed scalar, the equation doesn't change. This defines a new mathematical object which we call a circle. And we also say that the equation of the circle is what we get when we expand it out in terms of x squares and y squares. It's this thing here. And this is just the equation that explains to us when a point xy lies on the curve C. Let's have a look at some examples. First, let's observe that the equation of the circle that we had can be rewritten in the more standard form x minus a squared plus y minus b squared equals some number k. And it's not hard to see that the a and the b and the number k are uniquely determined because they can be read off from those three last coefficients in our proportion. So we could say that the circle is indexed by the pair AB, which is called the center of the circle, and the number k, which is called the quadrants of the circle. So some examples of circles where I write the equation rather than the proportion of six things. Here's the equation x squared plus y squared equals 1, which represents a unit circle whose center is at the origin, 0, 0. Here is a circle x squared plus y squared equals 2, which is the circle also of center 0, 0, but with quadrants 2. Here is a circle x squared plus y squared equals minus 5, also has center 0, 0, and the quadrants is minus 5. This is a circle that doesn't have any points lying on it, because over the rational numbers, squares are always positive, so it's not possible for x squared plus y squared equals minus 5. But nevertheless, it's very important to observe that this is still a circle by our definition, and it's going to be important in later developments that it is. And another example, x minus 1 squared plus y minus 2 squared equals 23. That's a circle with center 1, 2, quadrants 23. It's less obvious in this case that there are in fact no points that lie on that circle, no rational points. That's going to be a number theoretical aspect of the subject that's going to come up in our next video. But for now, let's just observe that this thing is still an example of a circle. Now let's have a look at how the notion of a circle relates to the notion of a line. Suppose we have a line, L, given by R to S to T, R, S, and T, some rational numbers. We say that that line meets the circle C with center A, B, and quadrants K, precisely when there is a point X, Y, which lies on both the line and the circle. So this pair X of Y has to satisfy, first of all, the equation of the line and the equation of the circle. In this picture here, for example, we've got two circles. There's a circle C with equation x squared plus y squared equals 2, which is center 0, 0, and goes through the point 1, 1, 1 minus 1. Another example is the circle D, whose equation is x minus 4 squared plus y minus 1 squared equals 4, which has center 4, 1 right there. Now, I've shown you in red some points that lie on the circle. However, it's not always the case that an arbitrary line that appears to cross that circle actually meets the circle. For example, if you look at the x-axis here and circle number C, if y is equal to 0, then x squared equals 2 has no solutions over the rational numbers. There is no rational number, as the Pythagoreans realized, that satisfies the equation x squared equals 2. That's telling us that geometrically, this line does not meet that circle, despite the appearances. And I indicate that with these little empty squares here. These little empty squares are points where the circle does not actually meet a line that goes through it, that seems to go through it. So that line there does not actually meet the circle. So when a line and a circle meet is a rather subtle number theoretical business. And it's a theorem that any line L and any circle C meet in either 0, 1, or 2 points. And to prove that, we're going to require a little bit of algebra using quadratic equations, so that will come a little bit later. Circles are rather interesting number theoretical objects. And it's wrong to think of all circles as sort of being more or less all the same. They are no more the same than stars in the sky are the same. In our next video, we're going to look at what points lie on circles. So we're going to talk about parameterizing the points that lie on a circle. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger, and thanks for listening.